So this is a 1.1 megawatt solar installation with a 1 megawatt hour of batteries. So it's one of the most significant solar battery projects in the state. Matter of fact, it's the biggest of its kind in the state.
We've got 35 tracker rows. And that single access is going to rotate over the east-west access throughout the day to maximize their solar gain. So the panels are going to be tilted to the east in the morning and shift to the west throughout the afternoon, and that's going to maximize their production and match the university's load demand curve.
One of the things that's really fulfilling about having our company located in the same town as Maharishi University of Management is that we are able to take interns on, and they get to have an on-the-job experience.
My name is Savannah Booth. I'm from Richmond, Virginia. I am a student here at MUM as well as an intern for Ideal Energy. I also work for the university in two separate job areas. I work for student activities as well as a resident advisor in the dorm hall that I live in.
The university actually has the what was originally the first four-year degree program in sustainable living in the country. So they've really been trailblazers in terms of having the vision of where the future is going, and then also what skills do we need to create that future. So, you know, for someone like Savannah, who's here exploring all the different avenues of sustainable living, you know, what does it mean to be in the solar industry? To be able to have students come in and learn those things right here in Fairfield as part of their sustainable living education is really huge. It's really cool that we're doing this groundbreaking installation at the university, and at the same time we're able to take on interns, and we are a company that primarily has alumni employees, so it's just a cool dynamic relationship that we've developed with the university in that way.
Maharishi University sort of fell into my lap more than it was me being attracted to it without having been here yet. I noticed that they offered a regenerative organic agriculture program online from seeing it on social media. And I told my dad, I was like, let's go visit. You know, I wasn't really interested in other colleges before. It just wasn't really my thing. And then I came here and I visited, and they talked about how they have a block schedule. I thought the meditation aspect was cool, and like the organic, mostly vegetarian food that was offered here in my own dorm room. And there was like the holistic aspect of why the school stood here was why I chose to come here. I was like, that's what I want to do. I want to get certified in organic agriculture so I can teach it.
Having us, the students now enter into the workforce that we're creating is really exciting, because that's where I started at the university. But we've been working with MUM students from the get-go.
MUM is definitely on the forefront of creating the next wave of leaders in renewable energy, creative thinking. Business owners, future business owners, are going to continue to help solve our environmental, societal issues.
I feel as if MUM is leading in sustainability by embodying sustainable principles in regards to our food, our mental state, our energy source, and through embodiment of these sustainable principles, we can have an effect on other systems of education and hopefully encourage more sustainable principles in education.
There's one thing that often comes up about the millennial generation, that maybe the millennials are lazy. It's so far from the truth. Millennials just aren't as motivated by money. I think they want to be impassioned. You know, they want to partake in something great.
It's inspiring for me to be working on this project because, you know, it's something that it feels good about it. And me, and as an individual, I do something if I feel passion and if my heart's in it. You know, otherwise there's like resistance within me. So it's important that my heart is behind this industry. And it is, because like I said, it's renewable energy and it's combating climate change and combating any of the negative detrimental effects to our environment. So it's inspiring for me to just get my hands in and to realize my young age and how I can influence, you know, I can embody myself as a leader for younger individuals to also feel inspired, and then they ultimately will expand the industry.
Leadership to me is finding that passion in individuals, finding it first in myself, cultivating that in those around me, getting them fired up, getting them to participate in what we're doing, and driving that out into the community, out into the city, into the state, into the world.